praise today. God has been a way maker for somebody. Give God praise today. You falling down, but you were able to get up. Give God praise today. And you almost fell out, but you got back up. Give God praise today. Amen. Not just for Peter and for us, but for the God that created all of us. I just want to say a couple things to Peter and about Peter. I still remember when Denver was a cheerleader, and we showed up at Veterans Park, and Coach Mayhall at the time saw a 2 or 3 year old Peter try to recruit him to be on the 70 pound team. He was like, Coach, he's 2 years old, he can't play yet. Just got to wait a little while. But I remember that. And I want him to know today that we're not proud of you just for sacks and TFLs and plays and rings and championships, but we're proud of you for a whole lot of other reasons. We're proud that you got your own style. We tried to dress this kid up many times, it just don't work. So we just roll with it. We're proud that you have your own mind. That he'll debate you to the end of the world if he really believes in what he's saying. We're proud that you remember that to whom much is given, much is required. We're proud that you set goals and you stick to them. We're proud that you didn't allow a setback a couple years ago to allow you to lose focus. And more than that, I'm proud that he's not too cool to hug his mom and to love on his sisters. I'm glad that he's that way. But more than anything, I'm proud that Peter is a person that wants to put everybody else on if he has an opportunity. There were so many times that we went to visit to other places, and he wasn't concerned about how we were going to get there. He was concerned about who he could take with him. I'm grateful for that. Kirk Franklin and Maverick City have a song. I'm not going to sing it, but they got a song called Bless Me. And the words made me think about Peter's experience. And the words say, bless me, God, not just for me, but so everyone around me can help everything they need. Let all these folks that's with me, God, have everything they need. That speaks to who Peter is. In closing, before we show the video, there's a little story in 1 Samuel 17 that talks about a little boy named David. And everybody knows the story of David, but what's interesting is that right before David goes to meet Goliath, Saul tells him to put on his armor. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
David says to Saul, that's not my armor. I can't wear that. And I'm proud that this boy understands that he don't have to wear everybody else's armor. That he don't have to live everybody else's life. That he's his own person. And we need to understand that today, that all of you that are in here today is not just for him, but for you. That you are enough. That you don't have to fit in somebody else's box. You don't have to do what somebody else told you they thought you should do. That you are enough. Who God created you to be is who you should be. Who God created you to be is enough. I'm glad that he knows that already, but I'm glad that he's going to show the world that. I'm out of time, but I ain't out of message, amen.
I'm out of time. It's your thing.
So we just got it. Hey, it's time to premiere. It's time to premiere, Coach Hayes. Cue the tape. We ready. Let's get it.
So hit the lights. Give us 1 second.
also get to meet the two line the sequel to the Todd, Florida, Clemson, and Jackson State.
Taking a chance on